Hello and welcome to the Drupal Academy. In this video, we will see how to allow the users to use their Google account for the authentication in the Drupal website. So using the Google Gmail credentials, user can log in into the website. In the last video, we have seen how to use the Facebook for the authenticate users in a Drupal website. I will add that video link in the description, or you can watch this video by clicking on this suggestion. For that, we have used the two modules. One is the social auth and second is the social auth Facebook. And for that, we have added the all details related to the Facebook. And now we will install the one more module for the Google authentication. That module name is the social auth Google. Go to this link. Scroll down. I will use this 3.0.0 version model. Copy this. I will install this model using the composer. For that, just paste this command and press the enter. It will download this social auth Google module. After that, we will enable this module. The module is downloaded. Now I will enable that module. So that command is dash en and the machine name of the module social auth underscore Google. The module is successfully enabled. Now again go to the configuration and the social app user authentication. So you will see the new tab will get added for the Google. In that, we need to add the Google app key and the secret key. So click on this tab. So here you can see we need to add the client ID, client secret. So for that, we first need to create the Google app. So for that, click on this console.developers.google.com URL. Login using your account. I will use this my account. Add your password. If you don't have any project created, click on this and create the new project. So first step is you need to go to the auth and consent screen. So this will be the parent app setting. And in that I will show you, I already created this. I will again show you by editing it. So first add the app name, user support email, upload the logo for your app, app domain. And next step is scope. In the scope, we need to select the which permissions we want from the user or the data which we want from the user. So we are collecting the email and the profile. Again, click on save and continue. Test users. Suppose if you want to add any test users, you can add their email address so that this app will be accessible to them. And press save and continue. These are the details which we have created for the app. Next step is again go to this credential. Which type of app you want to create? So I will show you that. Click on this create credentials. After that, click on auth client ID. Application type will be the web application because we are integrating this application with the website. Client name Drupal Academy test app. Add the, if you are integrating this app using the JavaScript, you need to add this JavaScript URL. And if you are integrating with using the Drupal, so go to there and copy this URL. Add URI, paste it here and click on create. So here you can see the client ID and the client secret. Copy this client ID go to the this configuration and paste your client ID here. Again, go copy the client secret, paste this in the client secret field. Don't share your client ID, client secrets with anyone, and save the configuration. The configurations are saved. Now go to the, we will create one block from which user will be able to access the URL for the authentication. For that, go to structure, block layout, click on custom block library. Now I will add the one custom block which will be display only on the user login page. Social login URLs, it will be only just the URL, http localhost php user login using Google. So after clicking on this URL, user will get redirected to the Google page for the authentication. So I will show you that also. Click on save. We'll change it to the login using Google. Save it. Now go to the block layout. Place that block in the sidebar first. Search for the block name, social login URLs. So it should be display only on user / login page. Click on save block. So block is placed. Now I will open the incognito window and I'll open my website user login page. So here you can see the that block is added for the login using the Google. Now I will click on this. It will redirect me to the Google login page. I'm getting one error. So the issue was related to the, after adding this configuration, we need to clear the cache. After clearing the cache, I will be able to go to the login page. To continue to Drupal Academy demo, this is the name of our app. Add their email address, and here you can see to continue, Google will share your name, email address, language preference, and the profile picture with the Drupal Academy demo. So enter your email address, contact. Add the password. So here you can see we have now successfully logged into the Drupal website using the Google. So this account is created. I will edit it, and again I will go to the admin users page, refresh it. Here you can see the last access was the 38 seconds ago. Again I will delete this user. I will log out from here also. Log out. Now again go to the user / login page. Now we don't have that user. I'll click here for the login using the Google. So my Gmail account is already logged in, that's why user is logged in automatically. So that's it from this video. We have successfully logged into the website using the Google app. If you have any doubts or suggestions, you can add in the comments. Please like the video and subscribe the channel. Thank you for watching.